Hi, it's Livitz, your friend, and I'm Alia. Today's is a requested video on how to embed external website for lesson and activities in Nearpod. I've already made a complete tutorial on how to use Nearpod. I will be sharing the link in the description box so that you can watch it later. So now let's get into this short video of the Nearpod series. Let's get started. This is the main page of the Nearpod. I have given every details about logging into the Nearpod in the previous video. This is how you see it, and you can click on the quick launch here to start a lesson straight away with activities. If you don't want to make a lesson, if you just want to make an activity, this is the perfect place. Now we are going to create a lesson to see how to embed the websites into the Nearpod. Now I am in the lesson, I am going to add a slide by slide. So this is the first thing, the web content, wherein I can add the web content. And then we have the option of adding the video or the YouTube link for the lesson. So here if I click this, it takes me to this page wherein I can add or search a YouTube and add that link to the lesson and save it once I am ready. So this is the first option. Now the second option is to add the web content. Click on the web content. You will be loading into the web content page. So we have click on the web content. We will be loading into the web content page. Open your YouTube in the next tab. Copy the URL that you want to paste and paste the URL. So once it is pasted, you can test the link using the click option below. And once it is all set, you can save it. Now this is not only for videos. You can also use the web content for saving URL of game apps or activity apps like Wakelet, Padlet, or Mentimeter, Mindmeister, or any of such applications which can be used as an activity in the classroom. Now we are going into the next option, which is found in activities. There is one more option here to add the videos. So here we have Flipgrid, which is an external website. Everything else is within the Nearpod. So we are opening Flipgrid in the next tab. I'm logging into my Flipgrid account. I have given a video on complete usage of Flipgrid, and I'll be again sharing the link of that video in the description box. So once we are into the Flipgrid, we can see that there are several lessons which I've already saved. I'm choosing a lesson from that, copying the URL of the lesson. Now note this, this is the URL of the lesson. So I'll paste that in the first box, and then I will click on the share button, copy the link over there and place the link in the second box. Save it for the students to start using it. Now we are saving the lesson here with a name and also with the grade for which we have prepared the lesson. So we are clicking on the save, give a name for the lesson and choose the grade for which the lesson is planned. I have made this lesson for grade 12. So once the lesson is saved, we will be again going into the main page of the Nearpod to see the lesson. Now we are going to access the lesson in a student paced way. So click on the option of view progress so that you can see the participation of the children. This is the first list where I can see the student's name who have joined the lesson. Now this is a trial lesson, so I don't have any students joining. The video, and then comes the activity that we are going to that we have already embedded. So it opens in the Flipgrid page. And you can see the option to view as a student. So click on that to see how your students can see the web page of Flipgrid. So this is how they will access. They can join using Google or Microsoft. Now I'm logging in using Google, and this is the page of the Flipgrid. So that's it. It's very easy. So please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.